Good morning. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. I'm not here to make trade recommendations. But I will conduct technical and fundamental analysis, and I'll do so in real time. Pip by pip, candle by candle, with the overriding goal of helping you put together trade plans throughout this beautiful New York trading session. If you're trading along with me using a demo account, then regardless of whether your plans are successful or not, you will have an opportunity to learn ya. Now, trading investing's risky business. We all know that. That's common sense. But what is uncommon is the high level of leverage that Forex offers you. As an amateur trader, once in a while you might get lucky and the leverage will seem to work for you, but more often than not, it's going to work against you. Therefore, the coaching staff at fxbootcamp.com recommends you do not trade real money until you have established a track record of success using a demo account. However, demo accounts are pretty cool. They're fun, you know. You get to play with all the indicators. Draw lots of lines, look for crossovers and ups and downs and patterns, because they contain things like price and time data. But what they do not include is real world risks such as greed and fear. Therefore, even if you do establish a track record of success using a demo account and you do move over to trading real money, you should remind yourself that your past success does not necessarily predict future results. Therefore, never resort to gambling by risking money you cannot afford to lose. Money is your product, money is your service, money is your inventory. You need inventory to be in business. Therefore, don't bet the farm. Stay small, stay humble, stay focused on your long-term success as a trading business. So what's going on, good-looking people? How do you maintain such beauty? Must be near the end of the week. I'm already tired. What's going on with that? What's up with that, huh? Is it Thursday? My gourd, it feels like a Friday. So guess what? Good news. We're starting the New York session, but I'm also going to do the Asian session tonight, and then I'm going to do New York again tomorrow. So you're going to get a lot of, crazy Uncle Wayne. Oh, Ruben says it's summertime. Yeah, you get a lot of outdoor time. Your skin is all tanned. Your hair is bleached from the pool water. Nice, Ruby. All right, so let's get going. So, what is going on with the yen? Let's do a yen scan. A yen. Carl, you don't have hair? I thought the Danes had thick manes of hair. Under their Viking helmets. So yeah, it doesn't look like yen is worth anything anymore, huh? That's cool. So we might want to focus on that. Don't you stink? So that's pretty cool. So we'll come back to that in a second. Let's go back to let's just do Euro USD since, you know, we're all familiar with it. Hang on a second. All right, so anyways, what I want to look at here, hey, look at that, I'm missing a chart. Oh, dang it. Where's my chart? Anyways. A couple of things right off the bat. You know, this is a good time of day to look at beep, 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 relative strength. Okay, yen is obviously a dog with fleas. Euro's neutral. USD's neutral. Pound is slightly weak, but nothing to freak out about. Swiss Frank is neutral. Kitty Cat strong. Ching, go Cat. Aussie strong. Ching, go Aussie. Kiwi strong again. Boom. What do these three currencies have in common? CAD represents oil. Aussie represents gold. Kiwi represents milk. Yeah. Bet you didn't know that. Google it, dude. Google it. So, commodities, huh? All right. All right. Fine. Fine. Yeah. Carl, hairs for women. You're so crazy. I like you. You're crazy. Crazy Carl. All right, so that's that thing. So we want to keep that in the back of our mind. Of course, you know, New York seems to have been, you know, find the strongest currency pair on the planet and short the hell out of it. That seems like the fate that we've been given over and over and over again this week. But anyways, actually this month. But other things to look at, you know, look all the European news here. Okay. Little disappointing. Well, let's, you're more specifically, like, let's take a look at this one here. Hello? Okay. German manufacturing, German PI, you know, a little less than expected. Not the good. Not the good. How about this? You like British pound retail sales? A little better than expected. All right. But look at, we've gone from negative 2.4 to positive 1.4. Hey, that's cool. You know, this figure always reminds me of back in the day when the British pound was just unbelievably strong. And, you know, the English were flying over to New York to buy iPads for half price. Whatever happened to that? Okay, we got a lot of news coming up today, 8:30. Okay, weekly unemployment claims. You know, I don't think that's a big deal. It's listed here as being a big deal. It's not that big of a deal anymore. We know things are bad, unless there's a huge shocker. Things are not improving, but, you know, still, you know, this used to be super huge. It's not that big of a deal unless there's a big shock. 10 o'clock Philly Fed. All right, we'll take a look at that. You know, some bunch of other crap. Not that big of a deal. And, oh, yeah, got to talk about FOMC, huh? So Crazy Uncle Wayne's been playing that down for a long time, right? And what happened? Essentially nothing. Extending Operation Twist. But, you know, I've been saying this, like, everybody's freaking out. Yeah, things are pretty bad in Europe. Yes, things are slowing down in China. Yes, things are deteriorating here in the U.S., but not enough for the Fed to freak out. Like, come on. Why does everybody freak out? Of course, I'm, you know, I had my heart amputated as a young man, so I don't have emotions. But maybe that makes me a good currency trader, but or at least a good macroeconomic economist. Because, look, here's the thing. The Fed's not going to get involved unless it needs to. It's already gotten more involved than any other central bank ever in the history of mankind, right? So it's done a lot, and it needs time. You know, central banking policy needs time. They're not going to get involved unless there's a crisis. I don't think you even want them to get involved unless there's a crisis. Do we have negative GDP yet? No. Has the stock market dropped more than 20% yet? No. You know, has consumer spending gone negative? No. You know, CPI, has that gone negative? No. I mean, why would they get involved yet? It's not their job to, like, save us every time, you know, there's a hiccup. It's not their job to freak out. So why does the market freak out? I mean, yes, things are not as good. But it's not warranted for like a full economy bailout like a QE3. So why would they be front running QE3? I don't know. Whatever. So an extension of Operation Twist. Whatever, dude. You know what I mean? Chill out, relax, take it one day at a time. Follow the fundamental trends in the data. You know, just so let it play out. Let it play out. Okay. So right now you can see people are not dumping the dollar per se. So right now let's just focus on the yen, etc., etc., etc. Right now it seems to be a relative risk on. You know, and that's really like just simply dumping the yen. This is the weakest I've ever seen the yen in a bajillion years, right? So right now it's sell off the yen. And where, if you're selling off the yen, where do you put your money? Ultimately, you put it into commodities. So let's just do that. That's just normal, common sense, you know, kind of stuff. Risk on, risk off. But it's, you know, just like I've been saying, it's not the end of the world. The sky's not falling. Don't freak out yet. I've been talking since April that the Fed's not going to get involved until we get like, the Dow back down to 10,500. We get crazy crosses on long-term moving averages. And we get negative CPI and, zero GDP growth, that kind of stuff. That's when the Fed should get involved. Hooah! Hoorah! So anyway, so we'll just play it as it goes, all right? And watch the trends in some of the, in the economic indicators and, you know, be logical about it. Be sane. Okay now, okay. So, Euro-USD... obviously, it's going to come back here. I only say that because of this EMA. There's a little news that just came out about Moody's is probably going to downgrade UK banking sector today. Maybe that's why this just got super strong. Look at the yen. Yen went from 0 to 1.2 in like 2 minutes. Dollar just gained a bunch of strength. Yeah, so now, see, look at exactly the opposite of what's been happening all night is now happening within 2 minutes. Downgrading the UK banking sector, huh? Wow. If you removed the banking sector from London, what would be left? If the banks fall in London, do they make a sound? Oh, the Olympic Games. Oh, I see. Great. There's always that. All right, so now we got to go probably a full reverse stop. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. I don't want to get involved in rumors here. No, let me remind you, Moody's has not downgraded the UK banking sector. It's just expected. All right, fine. Fine. So what do we do here? Let's start with Aussie. Everybody likes Aussie. Oh, not Aussie dollar. We don't need a buck. A buck here and a buck. Here, buck there, buck everywhere, buck. Let's go buck yen. Whoa, my love, my darling. All right, so we got to pay attention here. First question, are you a bull or a bear? Well, it's kind of hard to get bullish way up here. Gol dang it, here we are once again. So if we're at resistance, I might scalp for a while, right? So the next question is, are we at resistance? Daily R1, I have as 81.5 something.
a little higher up there. All right, closer to 82. Ooh, do we play the R1? No weeklies, no monthlies. All right, so we have moderate. Okay, we have moderate resistance. Midpoint psych level and perhaps a daily R1. Okay, so maybe. Time of day, check, roger that. All right, so, Is the dollar, or is the yen going to gain strength? Well, maybe on this rumor, that helps. So, is the 15 minute now overbought? So now I'm already going on to market conditions, right? So, are you a bull or a bear? Well, I can't be a bull here, so I might as well be a bear or do nothing. So I'm looking for a scalp trade. Time of day is fine. Are we at resistance? Moderate resistance, midpoint psych level, so it could be. Could be a rabbit. Next thing, what are market conditions? Overbought, oversold. Way overbought, trying to make a double cross on a 15 minute. Great, good to go. 5 minute wants to fall, 1 minute slightly out of cycle. All right, so now we're looking for trade patterns. How would you put, what kind of trade pattern would you look for? You know what, I kind of like either a fib, which would look like this, right? You could do things like double tops, right? Other things I want to look for full cycles here. So a pattern on the 1 minute Stokes would be like this. Here, let me draw that a little bit better for you. Beep, 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 beep. Let's just bust it out. All right, so I got permission on the five. So if we were going to get like a 1-2-3 pattern on a 5 minute scalp chart, you'd get something like this, right? Which means you'd get this, this, and then that, right? This providing our bottom, this providing our top, this providing a fib. You know what I'm talking about? Lower high, in other words, and we're good to go. Pretty simple, right? Cool. Hey, remember, if you're watching this as a recorded video, feel free to come to fxbootcamp.com and attend these sessions live. The guys in the cheap seats are going to be in the room for another 45 minutes or so. So come on by. And also leave a comment if you like the video. Give me some feedback, yo. Even if you're just saying hi, let me know you're alive. Let me know you appreciate it. Cheers. Oh, dang it. Stupid video won't turn off. Come on, you stupid video. Come on.